Hi, are you wondering if the Asus ROG Strix Scar 2 is a good choice among other gaming laptops? Today we're gonna check it out by reviewing it, testing in games, and comparing to the competition's laptops. Equipped with RTX 2070 graphics card, Scar 2 offers great performance while keeping the temperatures at respectable level, and the smooth display with excellent speakers translates all that power into a pure gaming experience. I'm very excited to make this video because I believe that I just found a no-compromise laptop for a good price. But before you buy, there are a few things that you should know about this laptop, so please take a few minutes to watch this review to the end and make a wise choice. As always, in the video description I left Amazon links for US and UK residents to check the current price and other configurations of Asus Scar 2. To skip to any part of this video, you can use the timestamps down below. I'm Chris from techfindscontact.com and now let's jump into the review. The unit that I am reviewing is the 2019 model with RTX 2070, but if it comes to design and build quality, it's the same for all the 2018 GTX models too. The top panel is made of metal with brushed aluminium texture and ROG logo that you can light up with RGB colors. The rest of the body is made of polycarbonate, and despite this is not metal, the laptop feels very solid and premium. On the deck you have carbon fiber texture with Amoro skin on one half, and what is characteristic for Scar 2 is the RGB light bar on the front of the laptop. The thing that I like is that the fingerprints are almost invisible on this laptop, so you don't have to bother with wiping it every day. I bought my unit in the UK and I love the design of it, but I don't love this large sticker on the wrist rest, which doesn't look good at all. However, I didn't see the same sticker on any of the US models. The device itself is pretty portable. Thanks to thin bezel display, it's smaller than most of gaming laptops, and the polycarbonate body helps to maintain lightweight, so carrying it every day should not be a big effort. This is how it looks comparing to the Acer Predator Helios 300. Inside you can see pretty decent interior without any red accents. The keyboard looks good, but what's more important, it's very comfortable to use. The keys have long 1.8mm travel distance and good spacing. The interesting feature, especially for gamers, is the overstroke technology, which registers the key press before you actually press the key all the way down. This might translate into an advantage in games, since your reaction will be registered faster, so if you ever needed just a few milliseconds more to not die or get a kill, with overstroke technology you might have been saved. What's more, you have 4 zones of RGB on the keyboard, and what I like the most about that is that every key has this transparent stroke, thanks to which you can see more light coming out of the keyboard. The WSAD keys in Scar are completely transparent, but there is also the Asus Hero 2, which is basically the same laptop as Scar, with the difference that the Hero is a MOBA version with transparent QWER keys and different pattern on the deck. Another advantage that I find very useful is that you have 4 additional keys. Starting from left, you have volume down, volume up, mic off and on switch, and the ROG key that opens up the Armory Crate software. Here you can keep an eye on the temperatures, clock speeds, hardware utilization, and control things like fan speeds or the lighting. The touchpad is decent size, it's smooth to the touch and accurate. It uses Windows Precision drivers, so it's got good gestures and tracking. You have also 2 dedicated buttons that work pretty well. I think it's a decent touchpad for a gaming laptop. If it comes to port selection, on the left side you will find power input, Ethernet, mini display port, HDMI 2.0, 2 USB 3.1 type A, 1 USB 3.1 type C without Thunderbolt 3, and 3.5mm jack for headphones and microphone. On the right side you have full-size SD card slot, 1 USB 3.1 type A, and security lock. The display is 1080p, 144Hz IPS panel with 3ms response time, but unfortunately without G-Sync support. However, with such powerful hardware, the G-Sync is not that useful. While gaming, I wasn't able to notice any screen tearing or ghosting, and the display worked very smoothly. Its color reproduction stands at 97% of sRGB, 75% of Adobe RGB, and the brightness is 329 nits, so it's perfect for gaming, but I would also use it for content creation without problem. Since this is an IPS panel, the viewing angles are good, and the backlight bleeding was impossible to notice during normal use, even on black screen. If you're watching this review, you most likely are interested with RTX 2070 model, and I will be talking about its performance soon, but there are also other configurations that I think are worth mentioning, especially now when the prices of GTX models dropped down. So the Scar 2 comes with both 15-inch or 17-inch variants, while the 17-inch models are indicated by GL704 number. but 15-inch and 17-inch models come with GTX 1060, 1070, and also RTX 2060 and 2070. I prepared a list with approximated prices for each model, but please note that the prices may vary with time, so in the video description I left Amazon links for US and UK residents to find the configuration that suits you best and check the current price for both RTX and GTX models. In some countries the SCAR 2 might not be available with GTX 1060 and RTX 2060, but there is a MOBA version of this laptop called Hero 2. It's basically the same laptop, but instead of transparent WSAD keys, it has transparent QWER keys, and a little bit different pattern instead of Moro on the deck. Coming back to the review, let's talk about speakers. I was surprised by the amount of bass that they can produce. Every shot and every explosion in game was full and punchy, so there was no really need to use the headphones. Mids are just on point, but the highs might seem to be a little bit overwhelmed by lows. You can always equalize the sound the way you want using Sonic Studio 3 software. These are the best sounding speakers that I've seen in a gaming laptop so far. If it comes to performance, my unit comes with RTX 2070 graphics card, i7-8750H processor, 16GB of RAM, 256GB M.2 NVMe SSD, and 1TB Seagate FireCuda hybrid drive. This setup provides enough power to play a lot of popular and new titles with 1080p resolution and maxed out graphics settings. Here is a quick preview of how it performs in games, just to give you an idea, but if you want to see more games tested, check out my gaming benchmark video, where I tested 20 different games on the Asus ROG Strix card 2, both with RTX 2070 and GTX 1060. You can find the link in the description or click the card above. Alright, so far so good, but there is one thing that you should definitely know. The SCAR 2 comes with single or dual channel RAM configurations. The thing is that the single channel RAM drastically decreases the performance compared to the same amount of RAM in dual channel. So I suggest you to get the configuration with dual channel RAM, or if you already have single channel, add one more RAM stick to take full advantage of the performance of this laptop. I made a video where I'm showing in detail how to disassemble and upgrade the Asus ROG Strix card 2, so you can check it out via the link in the description. As for the cooling, the SCAR 2 has 2 fans, 5 heat pipes and 3 exhausts. The air vents are located on the bottom, but there is also additional air vent above the keyboard. This combination keeps the temperatures respectively low. I tested the laptop playing demanding games for a long period of time with max fan speed. The average CPU temperature was 82 degrees Celsius, with average GPU temperature hitting 74 degrees. There was no sign of thermal or power limit throttling during my test. In the Armory Crate software, you can choose between 3 modes or set the fan speed manually. You have silent mode, which is the quietest one, but it limits the CPU power to 28 watts. The balanced mode limits the CPU power to 35 watts while the CPU and GPU are both in use, and to 40 watts while only CPU is under load. For gaming, you definitely wanna use turbo mode, which leaves the i7-8750H processor at its max power while the CPU and GPU are in use at the same time. For the CPU load only, it increases the max TDP to 62 watts. The useful feature that this cooling system has is anti-dust technology, which helps to keep it clean. In case if you would like to clean or repaste your laptop, there is one screw covered by warranty sticker, so I would recommend you to read the terms of warranty or contact Acer support before you do it yourself. If it comes to fan noise, under heavy load and turbo mode, the SCAR 2 seems to be slightly louder than other gaming laptops, but on the other hand, during basic tasks on silent mode, it stays completely quiet. While gaming, you should still be able to hear your gameplay thanks to great speakers that I mentioned before. The battery life hits around 4.5 up to 5 hours when browsing the web, watching YouTube, and doing light productivity work. When gaming, battery dies after 1.5 hour. I find it a decent score for a gaming laptop. Alright, as I mentioned before, we're gonna compare the Asus ROG Strix card 2 to other gaming laptops just to give you an idea of what you can choose from, since you might prefer some other laptop. Check out my channel or the video description, because there's a chance that I might have reviewed one of the laptops that I will be talking about now. So the first laptop that I would like to mention is the HP Omen 15, which has been recently released with RTX graphics cards too. Unlike the SCAR, Omen runs hot, but the advantage of it is price. Depending on configuration, it's more or less but always cheaper than Asus SCAR 2 with the same specs. It comes with few display options, so before you buy, make sure that it has the right panel. The 144Hz one supports G-Sync, but it's not as smooth as SCAR's display. The next laptop that you might like to check out is the MSI GE63 Raider. This one has the same good cooling as SCAR 2, good speakers and fast display, but what's special about Raider is that it has a great SteelSeries keyboard with RGB per key. It costs about the same price as SCAR, but you can also get it with up to RTX 2080 graphics card. There are also GTX models of this laptop that are worth attention to. As a budget option, the Acer Predator cannot be missed on our list. The new 2019 model of Helios 300 is coming out very soon with new design, RTX graphics and hopefully better cooling system. The previous generations of this laptop are well known for the best price to performance ratio out there. So the 2019 model will be most likely the new leader in its class. Subscribe my channel and hit notification bell if you don't wanna miss the review. The last laptop on our list is the Asus ROG Zephyrus S. This one is like a more premium brother of the Asus SCAR 2. It features up to RTX 2080 Max-Q GPU, and for the GTX, there is up to 1070 Max-Q option available. Compared to Zephyrus S, the SCAR 2 comes with max power graphics cards, so I think that it gives you much better bang for your buck. However, if you're looking for one of the thinnest and most premium laptops on the market, the Zephyrus S is the way to go. Alright, it seems to be everything that you need to know to make a wise choice. Check the video description to find Amazon links for the laptops that I mentioned and for more related reviews. And that's all for today, and I hope you found this video helpful. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments, and if you like this kind of reviews, it would be awesome if you hit thumb up or maybe consider subscribing TechFinds for more. On my channel you can find detailed laptop reviews, laptop comparisons, gaming benchmarks and more. Now thanks for your time and see you in the next review.